Hello students, welcome to Marine Engineering Tutorials. I am Atul Kumar Gupta and back with a new tutorial. Presently we are studying marine boilers. Today we have 19th lecture and the topic is types of gauge glasses used on marine boilers. We will also discuss the requirements of gauge glasses on marine boilers and their working principle. Water level gauge glasses play an important role in the safety and reliability of boiler operation. Following slides will discuss general information regarding gauge glasses. The requirements are that there must be two independent means of reading the boiler water level. It is normal practice to provide two directly mounted level gauges and a remote display readout for each boiler. The boiler gauge glass should be located in such a place from where the water level can be easily and clearly seen by the operator, and its bottom should be at least 6 inches above the topmost tube. Water level works on the principle that water maintains same level when two vessels are connected together. As the water level in the boiler is subjected to steam pressure, gauge glass is also provided with the steam pressure above the water level in the gauge glass, thus representing true water level as that in the boiler. The sketch shows the attachment of a tubular water level gauge glass to the boiler shell. Boiler gauge glass is directly attached to the boiler drum with the flanges. Each gauge glass consists of a steam cock, a water cock and a drain cock for its proper operation. After the water cock, a ball valve is provided to shut off the water passage and prevent excessive loss of water if the glass breaks. Glass tube is secured to steam and water cocks with packing cone. And nut, which also prevents the leakage from the joints. Plugs are provided at steam and water cocks for cleaning the passage. The cocks are operated with levers which remain in vertical position during operation of the gauge glass when steam and water cocks are open and drain is shut. Guards are provided around the glass tube to prevent its physical damage. This type of gauge glass is suitable for pressure up to 17.5 bar and was used on earlier ships as it has short life due to water solvent action. The sketch shows a plate type gauge glass which is suitable for high pressure boilers used on steamships. Gauge glass is attached to the boiler shell in a similar way as discussed earlier. Sectional view of the gauge glass illustrates its construction. So this is the sectional view through the gauge glass. The gauge glass consists of a centerpiece which has glass plates fitted on the other sides. Glass plates are separated from the centerpiece by gaskets, which provide cushion and prevent leakage. Mica strips separate the contact between glass plates and water. Toughened soda lime glass plates can withstand severe mechanical and thermal stresses and are protected from the solvent action of water by interposing mica strips. Gaskets are again placed between the outer case on the front side and the lower plate on the rear side. Outer case houses all the components of the gauge glass. Lower plate is used to deflect the light up, which is reflected downwards by the water meniscus and shows up as bright spot. Clamp plate secures all the inner components within the outer case, and jack bolts make the tight contact between them. So these bolts, jack bolts, are shown over here. A light source at the back is a must in this gauge glass to provide a clear view of water level from the front, which we can see from the viewing window. This figure shows tightening sequence of jack bolts. The bolts are tightened in several stages as per the sequence to prevent damage to the glass. Windows are provided on backside to provide light and front side to view the water level. This sketch shows a reflex type gauge glass, which is suitable for low pressure boilers used on motor vessels, and water level can be easily seen in this type. As shown in the sketch, some of the gauge glasses have needle valves with weighted levers for isolating steam and water passages instead of corks, as seen in the earlier types. Although the method of gauge glass attachment to the boiler shell is similar, the sketch shows cross-sectional view through the gauge glass, and let us see its components. Outer frame encloses all the parts of the gauge glass and is connected with steam and water passages. Reflex glass has vertical serrations, as you can be seen here, on the inner side, which make contact with steam and water. These serrations act as prisms, and light falling in steam and water spaces behave differently. In steam space, light gets totally reflected and it appears as bright shiny surface, whereas in water space it gets completely absorbed, thus giving a dull look. This contrast of bright and dull surface makes it easy to see the water level in boiler shell. Borosilicate glass used improves the service life of the gauge glass. centerpiece holds steam and water space which make contact with reflex glass plates. Gaskets used on either side of the glass plate provide it cushion and prevent steam and water leakage. Wedge piece is used to keep all the parts tied up with the set screw, shown over here. This gauge glass is suitable for pressure up to 20.6 bar as high pressure and temperature increases the water solvent action. All types of gauge glasses are equipped with arrangement to isolate the gauge glass in case glass ruptures. The arrangement consists of wires and handles to operate the cock levers from a safer position below the gauge glass to prevent injury to the operating personnel from steam and hot water. Now we will learn gauge glass blowing through procedure. Blowing through the gauge glass is an important activity to ensure safety and reliability of boiler operation. Purpose of blowing through the gauge glass is to ensure that steam and water cocks do not leak and it can be isolated for maintenance. Steam and water spaces are clear and the gauge glass will show correct water level. Procedure involves verification that the steam and water cocks are operating freely, they are not leaking, and their passages are clear. To check the tightness of steam and water cocks, they are closed and drain is opened. Once the initial contents of the gauge glass are drained, no more steam and water should come out from the drain. Thereafter, steam and water cocks are opened and closed one by one to ensure they are clear. This completes the blow-through process. To restore the operation of gauge glass, drain is closed and water cock is opened, which will take the water level to topmost position. Once the steam cock is opened, water will take the correct position as in the boiler shell. In this condition, nothing should leak from the drain cock. This sketch shows IGEMA remote water level indicator, which was used earlier to see the water level at a convenient height below the gauge glass. It consisted of a U-tube having a special red colored indicating fluid which was heavier than water and not miscible with it. It represented actual water level in the gauge glass proportionally in the viewing window. One leg of the U-tube was connected to the condenser reservoir, which was kept always full, while the other to the water space that varied as per actual water level. Some of the individual heights of water and indicated fluid multiplied by their respective densities maintained balance in each leg of the U-tube. So in equilibrium condition, we get capital H is equal to small x plus rho x, where rho is the density of the indicating fluid and capital H, small h and x are variables. If water level falls in the boiler, then H will reduce and X will increase. Thereby, capital H will increase, showing fall in the water level. The sketch shows a modern remote water level indicator which has used the concept of IGEMA remote water level indicator, with the difference that the readout can be provided anywhere without any restriction. It consists of a differential pressure transmitter connected between two legs. Leg connected with the condenser reservoir forms the reference leg, providing a fixed input signal which is higher than the other side. Leg connected with the drum side provides a variable input signal which is lower than the reference leg. An equalizing valve is connected between the two legs, which can be used to fill the condenser reservoir by closing the steam side valve. Drain valves are provided on each leg to remove the accumulated salts by blowing through when remote indicator is not being used. Differential pressure transmitter receives an input supply of 12 or 24 volts DC. Differential pressure transmitter gives a linear output over full range between 4 to 20 milliamps. Normal level shows 50% corresponding to 212 milliamps signal. Lowest level shows 0% corresponding to 4 milliamps signal. And highest level shows 100% corresponding to 20 milliamps signal. Pneumatic control system was used earlier, which represented the variation of water level by a linear output signal of 0.2 to 1 bar from differential pressure transmitter. This completes the study of direct and remote water level indicators used on marine boilers. This book is written by me and covers all the topics as per Indian Maritime University syllabus. It clarifies the concepts with simple illustrations. This book also provides answers to all the questions which have appeared in the examination conducted by Indian Maritime University. This book can help the students in preparing for the exam and also to work on the ship's boilers safely. Hope you have liked the lecture. You can write your feedback in the comment box. If you have liked the tutorial, you may share it with your friends. You may subscribe to the channel for getting notification about the new tutorials. I'll be back with a new lecture shortly. Thanks for watching till the end.